Hi, this is Tracy Fishko. I go to college in the city and my mom said I should call you. My mom is marrying your dad.
Do you want to hang out? Do you know where Times Square is?
Tracy!
Times Square is so crazy.
Isn't it?
I don't know anyone who lives here.
Yours truly. I got us the bus from Jersey. I thought this was the cool place to live. It's Times Square.
It's so stylish.
I know. I freelance as an interior decorator. You know the Bowery Hotel?
Oh my God, yeah.
Well, if you walk about a block south, there's a laser hair removal center that's very hip. I did the waiting room.
She lived exactly how a young woman should live. Who wants to spend her youth well?
Must we document ourselves all the time? Must we?
She did everything and nothing.
You don't know what you're selling. No one will know how to buy it.
What are you selling?
So many things.
Being around her was like being in New York City.
I'm an autodidact. Do you know what that means?
Yes.
That word is one of the things I self-taught myself.
It's so easy to see why Tracy like looked up to Brooke, because obviously one, she is new to the city, but even though Brooke was kind of a mess,
yeah,
she was still so confident and energetic that you can't help but admire her.
Right. Yeah.
But I was wondering, when you first started into this business, did you ever have somebody that was like your Brooke, like someone that you kind of admired or looked up to?
Yeah, I'm forever idolizing people. Some of them are older than me, some of them are my age, but I think a lot of what Tracy feels about Brooke, and being kind of intimidated by her too, and feeling like, oh God, I hope I'm doing this right. That's definitely something that was very close to me. I don't know. I spent a lot of time being very self-conscious and awkward, and those kinds of women would always be like, "Stop pretending to be self-conscious and awkward. You don't have to be." And then you'd get self-conscious and awkward about that. I definitely had people like that.
So Tracy has an interesting friendship with a guy and classmate.
Tony.
Yeah, she doesn't know if they're more than friends or not. And I'm not going to say how it plays out, but I can relate because I've been in that situation where you don't know if you're in the friend zone or not. But
yeah.
I was wondering, do you think that it's better to just, like, if you are in that situation, to just flat out ask a guy?
Oh.
Or wait to see if he makes a move?
Well, I mean, I think the truth is, I don't know that 18-year-olds have like the wherewithal or the confidence to be like, "Hey, brother, what's the deal?" Like, I feel like mostly you're just like, "I will awkwardly sit here until I figure out what's happening," and that's that's what Tracy does. And then you sort of feel like you're kind of mad at them when you find out that they're like, they have a girlfriend or something. But then you feel like you don't have any right to be mad at them because you never asked them anyway. And it's just, I felt like I had stuff like that constantly when I was younger. And ultimately you don't really, it's not even that Tracy wants to be with him.
Mm-hmm.
She just sort of wants to know why he doesn't want to be with her, which is a different question.
Yeah, yeah. I guess I do love it when you and Noah collaborate because, like I said, Frances Ha is one of the best films ever, honestly.
Oh, thank you.
And this is just another great film.
Oh, thank you.
And I think it's because you guys do such a good job of, like, portraying these characters who are kind of, like, hesitant of adulthood and kind of don't know what they want in life.
Yeah.
But you do it in a very real and genuine way.
Yeah.
But I know Frances was 27 and Brooke is 30, so I was wondering, would you say there's a difference in what you want when you're 27 versus 30?
Well, I think Frances and Brooke are like very different people. So in a way, it's less of like an age break for me and more of they just come from these totally different places. I mean, to me, Brooke is, she's so performative. She's always acting and she's always like putting on a show for people. And I think it really hides a lot of her own insecurities. So to me, it's like Brooke's anxieties are particular to Brooke.
Mm-hmm.
But I am interested in people who, whether they're 18 or whether they're like 60, kind of doing that thing where you have like an idea of yourself and then you have your life that you're actually living, mm-hmm. and trying to reconcile those things. I think it happens over and over again. I don't think it ever stops. I'm guessing this because I have talked to so many people who are like, old, or like with Frances or with this, or so many people have been like, "I am Frances," and I'm like, "But you're 70. How is that possible?" And they're like, "It just keeps happening."
Yeah. They'll need you. They'll want you.
You're funny because you don't know you're funny.
I know I'm funny. There's nothing I don't know about myself. That's why I can't do therapy. Can I start over?
Of course.
That was pretend rewind, like.
Huh.